CRISPR is in the news lately for being revolutionary. But what actually is it? In our body, there are trillions of cells. Deep inside these cells, there are genes and DNA.
It's like a very long instruction manual. It contains every information from your hair color to your behavior. But sometimes it can have errors causing many diseases. But don't worry, because there's a solution to this problem, and it is
CRISPR! But how does it work? Since the beginning of life, phages and bacteria are fighting. Phages insert their DNA to attack them, killing about 40% of the whole population. Those who survive save a part of the phages' DNA in a laboratory system called CRISPR. The colorful ones belong to different types of phages and the black is from the CRISPR system. When phages attack again, the RNA polymers quickly make a RNA copy of the DNA. The required part is sent to a protein called Cas9. Cas9 keeps it along with tracer RNA. Now the Cas9 is ready for hunting.
This Cas9 will stroll through the DNA and stick to PAM and start his inquiry.
Cas9 unzips and checks it. If it matches, it cuts the DNA, making it inactive. Researchers thought of using this same method to cut any gene of any cell. They jointed the CRISPR RNA and tracer RNA together to make a single guide RNA. They also made a plasmid of the whole thing to insert it into target cells. A DNA can be repaired in two ways. After cutting the DNA, it tries to repair itself in an error-prone way. Or it can send a repair template to fix it properly. Why is it revolutionary? It takes weeks instead of years, 99% cheaper, and more accurate than any other previous method. It can turn on or off any gene. It hopes to cure HIV, cancer, and genetic diseases. It can even design babies before birth. But it also can make mistakes, which can cause permanent damage to a species.
So, should we use this powerful but dangerous weapon? Now that's a question to consider. And thanks for watching.